ASIAE Senator James Orengo today launched a stinging attack against the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission, accusing it of having been turned into, and I quote, into a depository of cesspool of gossip, trivia, or tripe. Well, this was after detectives allegedly told him they were not ready to interrogate him on allegations made against him in respect to a visit in Madani family in Jinja, Uganda, and a parcel of land in Westlands. On his part, suspended Cabinet Secretary for Land, Kazungu Kambi, said he was included in the list of shame because he was a top performer. Patrick Amimo has more.
In the morning, and ASIAE Senator James Orengo walks in at Integrity Center for a grilling session over graft. After 2 hours, detectives are done with Orengo. One of the allegations facing him is attempting to acquire a parcel of family land measuring 0.1194 of an acre in Sondu. Orengo admits he made formal application to acquire the land in 2008 but abandoned the application after he failed to get a title deed.
It is most regrettable and shameful that Orengo can be accused of inheriting 0.1 acre of a piece of family land, 50 by 100 feet square, whereas there are people owning whole counties and provinces and will never take account.
Nobody has laid a complaint that we are aware of, so this is just malicious persecution.
You cannot look for somebody or witch hunt somebody for inheriting family property.
Orengo is also accused of visiting the Madhavani family in Jinja, Uganda. The Madhavanis operate a sugar mill in Uganda with some interest in Kenya. Orengo dismissed the claims. Detectives at Integrity Center told him that accusation is not in their files. Orengo also wonders why his name has been dragged into a land grab case on a piece of public land on Ring Road, Westlands, which has spanned more than 17 years.
What is happening now is not an investigation, it is an inquisition. And I've lodged a complaint to this commission that those who made the allegations against me should be investigated.
It is really shocking, and it is a sad day when a whole constitutional commission is turned into a cesspool of gossip and peddlers of rumors and trivia.
I support the war against corruption, but we want the commission to stop trivializing the war.
Suspended Labour Cabinet Secretary Kazungu Kambi checked in at Integrity Center before 7 in the morning, even before staff reported for work. He remained indoors with the detectives for 9 hours until 4 p.m. He narrated his experience.
We had a lunch break, yes, and a tea break. Yeah, so that's not the longest. In fact, I should be coming here frequently.
Kazungu is suspected of trying to swindle NSSF of almost 2 billion shillings by revising the cost estimate of NSSF Tasia 2 project via email circulation, despite clear indications that the Board of Trustees had not approved the revised cost.
The issues were basically that I've been working so hard on behalf of the ministry, so it's like I should slow down a bit.
Suspended Principal Secretary for Transport Nduva Muli was also grilled by detectives. He is accused of irregularly disposing Kenya Railways properties while serving as managing director. He is also accused of influencing an irregular award of standard gauge railway tender to a Chinese firm. Just like his suspended boss, engineer Michael Kamau, Nduva refused to field questions with the media. The first week of investigations has seen 3 suspended cabinet secretaries and 2 suspended principal secretaries report at Integrity Center for investigations. Detectives here will have to prove that the investigations are not driven by malice or political witch hunt. Patrick Amimo, KTN, Nairobi.